Hello and welcome to the Map Framework tutorial video for Map Backup. In this video, you will learn what features are included in the backup framework, what gets imported, and the required modifications to fully integrate the framework into your application. The Map Backup framework allows you to easily create and restore a backup of the application. You can choose whether you would like to automatically backup the project at a predefined interval. The optional MapView frontend includes the ability to create and restore a backup, as well as view a list of available backups. As time goes on, additional features may be added to the Map Backup framework. Be sure to check the help file of the latest version to see the full list of current features. The steps to import a mappFramework component are described in the overview video at the top of this playlist. If you haven't already watched that video, please do so now. After import, a backup package will now appear within the infrastructure package of the logical view. The corresponding backup manager task contains a number of files, which we will now go through one by one. BackupManager.st is the main task code which sets up the map function blocks and contains all of the necessary code to create, restore, and delete a backup. Next, we have the local type and variable definition files. The Hmi Actions file contains all supporting code for the Hmi functionality. This includes the file manager handling. The Change Configuration file contains the programming to modify the backup configuration at runtime. Modifications to this file are typically not necessary. If you imported the MapView frontend, then relevant content files are included in the framework package within the Pages package. You will need to assign the backup content to an area on a page within your visualization. The localizable text required for the HMI is included within the mappFramework Texts package. If you did not import the MapView frontend, then you will need to connect the HMI backup variable structure elements to your visualization. Moving on to the configuration view, a backup package gets added to the map services package. Here you see the map backup core configuration file, as well as a file manager UI file. Next, a modular OPC UA default view file will be added to the connectivity package. The TMX files used by the backup framework will be merged into the TMX files for target list in the text configuration. Some users and roles are added to the corresponding files within the user role system. All default user passwords are 123, capital A, capital B, lowercase c, and should be changed after importing the framework. If you imported the MapView frontend, a backup package will be added to the MapView package, which includes all binding and event binding files necessary for the backup framework. The items required for the backup framework will be merged into the .viz file you selected during import. Lastly, in the CPU configuration, a few things have changed as well. If your user partition is less than 256 MB, the value is increased as such. Two file devices are merged to the file device list. If you imported MapView and OPC UA is not yet enabled, this will be enabled for you. In addition to the required modifications mentioned previously, there are some optional modifications that you may want to consider. For example, you may want to change the file device to something other than the user partition. For more details, refer to the corresponding section in the help. The map backup content can be viewed immediately after project installation via the framework demo page in MapView. Here you can view the list of available backups, as well as create, delete, or restore a backup. Note that the ability to restore or delete a backup on the MapView HMI is restricted to the administrator's role. To demonstrate this here, I have also imported the MapUserX framework. The default administrator user is admin with the default password 123 capital A capital B lowercase c. Also remember that a backup cannot be created or restored in ARSim. The settings button allows you to set up an automatic backup. And with that, we conclude our overview of the Map Backup framework. Please feel free to check out the additional Map Framework tutorial videos within this playlist.